Hi, Gemini. Welcome to your October 2021 General Tarot reading. It's Raina here. I already have an astrology reading up on my channel for your sign, so you can go check that out. If you're interested in the general astrology, I will say that you have a new moon in a very fun area, the fifth house, which is about pleasure and love. And because this is a Mercury retrograde, it's happening during a Mercury retrograde in Libra, the sign that the fifth house is in, that could mean hearing from somebody from your past that was like a love interest, okay? So, anyway. And somebody, you know, very politely suggested that I get the kind of, you know, thing that you can film overhead. And I think I'm going to get something like that, you know, something simple like that. So I will hold up the cards, though. So if you can't see them, you still will be able to. So the heart of the matter is the Hierophant. This is a card of tradition, including marriage. And this is kind of a little bit of a loaded issue for some Geminis. Because you like your freedom, you like variety. So when things get familiar, that might seem like boring to you. And let me bring the past card here. We have the Eight of Swords. This is a card of feeling oppressed, feeling like you are trapped in a situation. Now, with the Eight of Swords, this could be within yourself, what you're telling yourself. So it's of your own making, I guess you would say, whether it's something that you are choosing to believe or it's like old tapes running. And old tapes may be coming from other people, but at a certain point, the individual chooses whether or not to believe in those things. You know, things happen, but that doesn't mean you have to continue to believe them as you get older. So one of the ways this can manifest is like if you feel trapped in a marriage, and yet you feel like you have to uphold some kind of tradition, or the Hierophant is like religious beliefs and stuff like that. So if you've been kind of I'll use the word indoctrinated, not to put down certain religions, but you know what I mean, then that can keep you rooted in place and make you feel like you can't be a free agent, like you can't do what you want to do. And remember that Gemini is sandwiched in between two more traditional signs. So you can have personal planets in either Taurus or Cancer, or maybe a combination thereof, and that can also influence you and make you more traditional. But having that Gemini side, you know, a lot of people have these mixed influences, and it does create this sense of contradiction within the person where they feel like they are of two minds. Well, of course, Gemini feels like they're of two minds anyhow. The higher message is the Knight of Wands. To me, this is telling you that this is who you are at your core. You're somebody who loves freedom, is not necessarily easy to pin down or to keep contained. This is a very fiery type of an energy. This is connected to Sagittarius. I also think Aries might be how this plays out. And As a spiritual message, it's like not being something that you're not. Like if you are more of a person who is adventurous, then that's who you are. And you can't conform to what other people's expectations. Maybe that was a mistake that you made, and you're still playing out those kinds of false identities, and that is creating conflict within yourself. What crosses you is the Fool card, and this is interesting because you did have a new mo a moon that was actually a solar eclipse back in June, and to me that would have been in conjunction with this Fool card in terms of a new chapter in your life. That it's like a solar eclipse is like a new moon on steroids, so that sense of forward m motion at the time of your solar return, or around the time of your solar return. So maybe you felt that you haven't been able to start a new chapter of your life for some reason. You have unfinished business. Well, maybe it has something to do with a relationship that is outworn, that needs to go, that is oppressive. Maybe for some people, your destiny is to be in this partnership, and you are rebellious because you don't want to be that person that settles down. You look at settling down as being a conformist behavior. The truth is, Gemini, that the person who is right for you is the person who honors your need for freedom. So if you're with such a person, then you know you're in the right place, and you don't have to fear committing to this person because they really want the best for you. If you have doubts about that, then that's a different story. But don't throw the baby out with the bathwater. If you know that you have somebody who is freedom-loving themselves, then you're going to be making a good choice. And that's the thing, is like, if you have met somebody new, but perhaps you're afraid of the unknown, and that's how I would see the Fool card in the challenge position, and afraid that in leaving a marriage that you don't know what is lying ahead of you. The truth is that sometimes that's true. We're kind of walking out on faith, but we know that what we have now is oppressive. We know that it's not something that feels good. So I can understand being apprehensive about what the future holds, but when you know that the present is providing, you know, that's why I'm saying the present, actually, yeah, an ongoing situation isn't very pleasant, then to me, it stands to reason that you really don't have much to lose. What is coming in is the Page of Swords. This can be a card of being on high alert, and seeing, watching your back, seeing what is going on around you, like being very aware. Can also be starting a relationship with somebody, perhaps that has a strong air element, somebody who is intellectual, verbal, maybe a teacher, a writer. You're nurturing this relationship. If you are someone who is in the process of getting married, you would be looking at, you know, this can be a card of research, so looking up reception halls and where you're going to get married, or where, you know, if you're going to move in together, if you're going to have a commitment ceremony, those kinds of things. So researching things like that. The outcome card is a card of marriage, okay? So when I was starting this reading, because I was looking at the Hierophant, I was thinking the same thing, but this is interesting because this is actually a card of marriage. So the first and last cards are connected to marriage. But see, marriage or commitment, and that may be the area that feels a little bit shaky to you because perhaps since this is in the past position, this Eight of Swords, maybe you have memories of feeling trapped in relationships and you don't want to repeat that. So, this feels so permanent. But yes, if you have been on the fence about something, it's suggesting that marriage is something that you will commit to, however that looks for you. And when I say marriage, I mean committed partnership. This is also like the card of happily ever after. That's why they have the rainbow and that idea of the resolution of something in a positive way. The number 10 is a number of resolution. So I hope that you enjoyed this, Gemini. And certainly the emphasis on the fifth house corresponds with love matters. So it does seem like it might fit for some of you at least. If you would like a private reading, I do mainly astrology readings, and I have double readings that are on sale. So you can check out all my offerings at Rain and Moon Astrology. The link is below. Thank you for watching. Take care. Bye.